how to read chest x-ray and what are the technical aspects you should consider before reading a chest x-ray. Hello friends, chest x-ray peer review is the most asked investigation by clinician. So it is very important to know how to read the chest x-ray and the basics of chest x-ray. So I'll tell you today about some technical aspect of chest x-ray, how you will read x-ray chest peer review, and what are the things you will consider before concluding to a diagnosis. So let's start. First thing, after getting a chest x-ray to read, first thing you have to see that what is the name of the patient. So name of the patient will be written here or somewhere here. So that is important. Then date, which date the x-ray was done. Then right or left, see somewhere here right or left it will be written. This is important. And lastly, what type of view is this? Is this a PA view or AP view or lateral decubitus view or any other type of view? So view will be written. Usually routinely we do chest x-ray PA view to see any opacity or any pathology in the lung. So other views we do in different situations that I'll discuss in some other videos. What are the other types of views are there? So for this PA view, we'll consider this type of thing. Next point is whether the X-ray is expiratory or inspiratory film. If the ribs, you count the ribs, the sixth rib, if it cuts in the mid of the diaphragm here, sixth rib, anterior end of the sixth rib, if it is, it touches the midline of the diaphragm, then it means this is an inspiratory film. Why inspiratory film is important? Because inspiratory film, we can see the whole volume, volume of the lung, both sides we can see clearly, we can see the heart shadow properly. In expiratory film, we usually miss the lower zone, any opacity or any abnormality in the lower zone. So it's important. The next point, the film should be taken in arrested respiration. I mean the patient should be in inspiration and patient should hold the breath. Why? Because it minimizes the movement of heart and it minimizes the movement of diaphragm also. This was the second point, and now comes the third point. Whether the X-ray is of correct density, I mean whether it is properly penetrated film. How will you know? If the vertebral body from 1 to 4, first to fourth vertebral body is clearly seen and ribs are clearly seen behind the heart, that means it is of correct density. Why it is important? If the x-ray is of correct density, then we can compare both the lung properly, we can see the heart shadow properly, we can see the angles clearly. So that is important. The next point is the scapula should be clear of lung failure. Why? Because if scapula is clear of lung field, then only we can see the apex of the lung and the periphery of the upper lobe clearly. So that is another important thing. And the last but not the least is clavicle, medial end of clavicle should be equidistant from the lateral wall of body of vertebra. The medial end of clavicle should be equidistant from the lateral side of the body of vertebra. It means, if it is so, it means the patient is in proper position, patient is in straight position. In PA view, what happens? Patient face the X-ray film and patient would be straightly faced, not in an oblique side or rotated to some side. Patient should be straight. So, if the clavicle is equidistant, that means the patient is in correct position, and by this we can see any, we can detect any deviation of trachea, I mean whether the trachea is in midline or not. we can compare opacity of both the side. So these are all points, technical points you should consider before detecting any pathology or before reading the chest X-ray. So that's all for today, and hope this video will be helpful for you. Thank you for watching.